nighttime, Stone Mountain Park lit up with Christmas lights everywhere. We walked through the glow to play a nighttime round of mini golf. This golf course is themed after the Great Locomotive Chase. I don't have time to tell you the whole history in detail, but here's an overview. Once upon a time, it was April 1862, and Conductor Fuller and his passengers got off their southern train to eat breakfast at a hotel. The spies were carrying out a carefully crafted plan to tear up railroad track and cripple southern infrastructure, in conjunction with federal troop movements. If it had worked, the war might have ended earlier. But Mr. Fuller, the brave conductor, wasn't about to let them get away with stealing his locomotive. He chased them on foot, on a rail-mounted pole car, and in several trains, one of which he drove backwards. Fuller's incredible perseverance paid off. The Federals couldn't stand the pursuit, the general ran out of steam, and the Federals ran away into the countryside. Most of them were rounded up and were convicted of spying. Now, Disney made a film of this story. The chase part of it was good, but despite what the film showed, the true hero of this story was Conductor Fuller, not the spies. Well, we finished golfing and got on the sing-along train, the same train we'd rode earlier, except with songs. We rode through the night singing Christmas carols and other songs while looking at some Christmas lights. We were happy to find out they had a stop where a lady told a fairly accurate account of Jesus' birth and explained why we celebrate Christmas. Back in town, we bought us some funnel cake and watched a satirical play of the Christmas Carol. The night ended with fireworks illuminating our southern heroes, Davis, Lee, and Jackson. That was the end of my chronicling. We had left Keystone 18 hours earlier, and I was sleeping soundly from the mountain back home.